Winter's clearly over. Now you might be able to see here where somebody's actually made a cut in this tree to be able to peel birch bark off and how it scarred itself up here. And that is the absolute wrong way to be able to collect birch bark. And for those of you guys who watch the channel a little bit, you guys know that birch bark is my absolute favorite way to start a fire. But this is the wrong way of doing it. This actually damages the tree. When you're just pulling off the pieces that are already peeling up, that doesn't hurt the tree at all. But whenever you go in and you start making gouges in it to be able to peel stuff back like that, that's the wrong way to do it. Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel, Old Southern Pine. So today I am completely running solo. I am hiked in a little bit through the woods and then came out on an old logging trail, and I'm actually camped just off to the side of the old logging trail. But it is right next to a beautiful little lake, kind of very tucked back into the Minnesota forest. I've got the folding portable fire pit that we're going to set out right out here in front of the tent and have a great little meal. First time I've ever cooked this, so hopefully it turns out all right. We've got a brand new tent from Kazoo Outdoors. It went together really easily, even with stopping and filming. It only took me about 10 minutes to put this together, and that's even with filming. So that's it was a nice tent. It's definitely not what I would consider to be a backpacking tent. It's a little bit heavier, but there's a lot of room inside. It's got a great vestibule out on the front where it kind of opens up on the front and back. So I'm very pleased with that. Welcome to home for the night. They're definitely calling for some rain and thunderstorms to happen over the course of the evening. So I'm really kind of hoping for that. That'll be a really great night, especially if we can get some, you know, some thunder and lightning over here across the lake. That'd be really pretty to film. We've got a little bit of time before dark, so I'm going to collect some firewood, get that processed up, and get ready for a great evening. All right, guys, well, this is my very first time making venison stuffed peppers. I gotta tell you, I'm pretty pleased with myself for how it came out. I am not what you consider to be a culinary expert by any stretch of the imagination, but this is pretty darn good. So I'm gonna sit back, I'm gonna enjoy this. I'm gonna enjoy this beautiful view of the lake and this nice fire, and I will catch up with you guys shortly. All right, guys, one of the things that I love about having truly quality titanium cookware, like Silverant Outdoor, is simply because when you get done with it, doing dishes is so easy. All you do is you stick it right back on the fire. You can see that pot right there, it's smoking. Once it's done smoking, there's nothing left in it. So like example, here was the skillet that I used, and this is just nothing but ash. You wipe that out real quick. It is done and ready to use again. Clean as could be. All right, guys. Well, dinner was absolutely amazing. We've got the dishes done. The fire is out. That rain has finally started to come in a little bit. It's just sprinkling right now, but you know, hopefully it'll pick up here soon. I'm going to go ahead and get into the tent. It's raining just enough that you just don't want to be outside and get yourself wet. So I'm going to get into the tent. I'm going to watch a movie that I've got saved onto my phone, and I'm just going to have a fantastic night. You can hear the peepers going. I can hear some geese off in the distance off to my right here. So I'm really excited about this. So I'm going to get in here. I'm going to get curled up, and I'm really just going to have a fantastic night. With that, I will catch up with you guys first thing in the morning for breakfast and coffee. Good night. I hope you guys can hear the wind. It is just howling right now. The rain is finally starting to pick up, and I can just get a little bit of heat lightning coming in through the tent. I am really excited about this. I'm hoping it's going to keep up. I'll turn the camera back on if anything gets exciting. Otherwise, I'll go ahead and say goodnight. Good morning, guys. That was such an awesome night. We had a little bit of a rain and wind and lightning storm that came through, that which was absolutely beautiful to watch it lighten up the tent. And about 4 o'clock in the morning, about 15 Canada geese, which I guess had been roosting in trees nearby, flew down and went back into the lake that's here behind me. And I didn't know that Canada geese roosted, but sure enough, you'd hear them rustling in the leaves, and that very much just like a turkey does, where it kind of pomp, 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 pomp as it comes down. So, but all the while making the cacophony that only geese can make. It was really, really neat. So, great night. I slept really, really comfortable in this Kazoo outdoor tent. It is a little shorter, so I'm 5'9". You were any taller than I am, you could get a little tight in here, but it was perfect for me. Plenty of room. It's definitely a two-person tent for sure. So yeah, great night, and we'll check back in with you guys in a little bit for breakfast and coffee. Good morning. right, guys, so it is an absolutely beautiful morning. The sun is bright and shining. It's actually already quite a bit warm. I'd say it's probably 65 degrees Fahrenheit. So I'm going to have some cheesy grits, some coffee, and some bacon, and sit here and enjoy this beautiful morning. Cheers. Oh, yeah, that's good. And I didn't even burn the bacon this time. All right, guys, breakfast is done. That was absolutely delicious. The dishes are on the fire, so those are getting cleaned off. So I'm going to sit here, enjoy the rest of this morning, looking out over this beautiful lake, enjoying my coffee. As usual, I'm going to spare you guys the pack down process. I am literally going to take everything, roll it up into a big ball, shove it in my backpack, and then just deal with it when I get home. One thing that I will say, though, is that it's extremely important that whenever you guys are packing in, take care of the place that you're in. Leave no trace. I mean everything. Pack everything up. All of the trash that you have, it all goes back into the bag. It all goes into my pockets. Make sure you're doing the same. Take care of it. Take care of these places for everybody else. And so that you can come back and enjoy it. Nobody wants to come back to filth. With that, I'll end it here. Until we meet again under the old southern pine, stay safe. God bless. Winter's clearly over. Anybody know what kind of snake that is? That's a big snake for around here. That's got to be 4 feet long. You know what kind of snake that is? Leave it down in the comments.